Well, I might as well try one more before it gets too cold out here. It's going to get cold next week. We had the video of the bars in a jail cell. Imagine there are bars of a jail cell, and you're behind those bars. Does it matter what the bars are made of in terms of the fragrance of truth coming through the spaces between the bars? Does it matter if the bars are made of titanium? Does it matter if they're made of, you know, case-hardened steel, carbon fiber, plastic, resin, stone, silver, iron, bronze? Does it really matter what the bars of a jail cell are made of when it comes to the fragrance of truth being able to go through the bars and reach the ones behind the bars, reach us? It doesn't matter what they're made of, does it? It doesn't matter. The fragrance moves right past them, through the spaces between them. Spaces between them are the same, whether it's made of titanium or gold or whatever. So, it's very important. Now, these bars could represent our problems in life, our life problems. I had a terrible dream last night. It could represent a terrible dream. It can represent all this stuff. And as a matter of fact, the dream was so bad that I had to ask the Holy Spirit. I couldn't get free of it. What do I do? What do I do? What do I do? And the Holy Spirit said, how does light see light? I said, huh? Yeah. We know we view light. We're viewing light. But how does light view light? How about light seeing light? Light seeing light. Light seeing light. How does light see light? And that took me out of the troubles, so to speak, thinking about that. And then I realized all these problems we have, like bars in a cage, don't matter at all. In terms of remembering reality, the fragrance of truth goes right past those bars, wherever they are. Whatever they are, that means it doesn't matter what our patterns of sensation are at all. Doesn't matter what we are, where we are, but our patterns of sensation. What we are is just a pattern of sensation, really. Constantly changing. It doesn't matter. Those are the bars of the cage. Sensory perception are the bars of the cage that we're in, the prison that we're in. But the fragrance of truth goes right past those bars. Whatever they are. So, it doesn't make any difference. Your patterns don't matter. My patterns don't matter, your patterns don't matter, nobody's patterns matter. Nobody is far away from the fragrance of truth, because the fragrance of truth can pass through any kind of bars, no matter what the bars are made of. The bars can be made of soap, right? Bars could be made of bamboo. Can be made of millions and millions of different structures. Doesn't matter. Fragrance of truth moves past those bars no matter what. Doesn't make any difference to truth. Doesn't make any difference to the fragrance of truth. Doesn't make any difference at all. No difference at all. It doesn't pay any attention to what they're made of. Stainless steel. It can be stainless. Titanium bars. Doesn't matter. So, it really doesn't matter where we're at. We are saved by grace entirely. Works don't matter at all. You take the most hardened criminal in the world, the fragrance of truth moves past their patterns, their bars, patterns of sensation, just as freely and easily as they move past the bars, the patterns of sensation of some great philanthropist. No difference. No difference. So we spend all this time trying to change the patterns of our perception, meaning trying to change what the bars are made of. And that's a complete waste of time. Doesn't matter what they're made of. two bars here. Doesn't matter what they're made of. The fragrance comes right through those two bars. The fragrance of truth. Truth has a fragrance to it, a sweetness to it. That sweetness and fragrance reaches us behind those bars, behind the bars of our sensations. Everything is just a sensation. The flesh is just swimming in sensations. We're all just patterns of sensation. Habits of sensation. That's it. Flesh is nothing more than sensations. But that can't keep out the remembrance of reality. Remembrance of reality goes right through it. Doesn't block it. You don't have to have special bars. Change the composition of them. It has nothing to do with it. So we are saved by grace, meaning your works have no bearing on it whatsoever. None. Nobody's works has any bearing on it. Because all we need is remembrance of reality. We don't need to change anything. We don't need any patterns of sensation. We don't need any special patterns of sensation. We simply need remembrance of reality. Remembrance was facts. Remembrance of facts. Facts, truth. Facts have a fragrance to them, a spiritual fragrance. And that spiritual fragrance reminds us of reality. So, nobody is any more resistant to it than anybody else. Nobody is any less resistant to it than anyone else. It's impossible to... There is no resistance to it. Nobody has any resistance to it. But we have to accept that because our denial of this, like a pressure system, keeps it away from us because we don't want it. We say, I don't want that. I want to show that I'm more deserving than someone else of this. Now, it's amazing when you see this and recognize it, then you can accept detachment from your psyche, that just detaching from your psyche. Your psyche doesn't matter. Nobody's psyche matters. Psyche doesn't matter. Patterns of sensation don't matter. Nobody's patterns matter. All we need is remembrance. That solves the continuity problem. That's it. That's all that God is involved with, is remembrance of reality through the Holy Spirit, reminding us, giving us remembrance of reality. And sensation can't give us remembrance of reality at all. There's a spiritual experience that's different than the flesh-based experience. Our senses cannot apprehend anything that reminds us of reality. They cannot. But they cannot stop either. They can't stop the fragrance of facts reaching us, reaching our spirit. So it doesn't matter what's going on in the world. It's irrelevant. At any given moment, it's entirely irrelevant. because it doesn't block the remembrance of reality. It's never blocking it. So why are we paying attention to it? It's never blocking it. It can't give it to us, and also it can't block it. So these patterns of sensation are what? What are they? I mean, do we need to really pay attention to them? We call these patterns of sensation our life. It's ever changing, fluctuating, and all this. So we're nearing, October, the end of October, which is always the most auspicious time. For me, it's always been October, around the 27th or 28th of October, has always been the most auspicious days where the fragrance of reality, fragrance of truth, has reached me in days gone by. For some reason, that's when it happens. All it's necessary is just realize that no bars can block this remembrance. So it doesn't. You don't have to pay attention to the bars anymore. What are they made of? It doesn't matter what they're made of. Marble, limestone, you know, granite. It doesn't matter. So it doesn't matter what anyone's patterns are. It doesn't matter at all. Totally irrelevant. Doesn't matter what anyone's personality is, totally irrelevant. Doesn't matter what anyone's problems are, totally irrelevant. Problems don't block it. Nothing blocks it. Problems are just simply, you know, pattern of sensations that we don't like. Whether we like the sensations or don't like them, none of that makes any difference. It doesn't block. It doesn't have any blocking power. We spent all our time trying to remove these blocks, remove these bars, and we never had to spend a second at it. Doesn't matter if they're blocks. The goal is not to remove the blocks. The goal is to be reminded of reality. And blocks do not block that remembrance at all. So it's a complete waste of time. You can say, I've completely wasted my time. You know, that's, I guess, you know, the realization that everyone needs to come upon is to see that. Say, I never had to do anything. In fact, nobody ever had to do anything. No one's ever had to do anything. No one will ever have to do anything. We're all free this very instant. End of October, these are the clarifications that are coming. I had a terrible dream last night. Really? It doesn't matter. The conflict, severe conflict. It doesn't matter. That doesn't block it either. Nothing needs to be resolved. Nothing needs to be changed. We don't need to make any progress. Nothing has to happen. Nothing has to happen for anyone. For any dance of sensation. Oh, this is all just Maya. It's just a dance of sensation. It doesn't make any difference what the dance is. Doesn't block remembrance at all. So we can say, the most positive thing we can say is, hey, I've wasted my entire life. Most people are terrified to accept that and see it. So they end up wasting the rest of their lives too. From the moment you see, hey, I've wasted my entire life completely, from that moment, you're not wasting it anymore. But if you keep denying your whole life, then at the end of your bodily life, you'll say, oh my gosh, I wasted it all, entirely. So die before you die, because then you aren't dead anymore. Death is gone. Your forgetfulness of reality is gone. Your search for sensations is over. So, if we can say, yes, I've wasted my entire life, it's a positive realization. Oh my gosh, I never had to remove those blocks. All those patterns I had in previous lives and stuff, that problematical. I didn't have to do anything about anything at all. Totally unnecessary. It's always been unnecessary. Everything has just been a waste of time. Totally unnecessary. Complete waste of time. Wasted every moment of my life. I've wasted every moment of my life. There's something positive to say. Hey, I've wasted every moment of my life, which is true. And you can accept that and see it and realize it. And then you say, hey, I don't have to waste any more moments of my life. I don't have to be working on removing the blocks to the presence of love. There's no need to remove any blocks. That's the whole scam. The con is to think you need to do something about it. There are no blocks to the presence of love, presence of reality, the fragrance and sweetness of truth. There are no blocks to it. There's nothing blocking it. There's nothing preventing it from getting to us and reminding us. Nothing at all. Nothing standing in the way. Never has been anything standing in the way. So, you can go from this feeling like, I've wasted my whole life, and feeling very depressed because you think you'll keep on wasting it. You can change that into a very positive feeling like, wow, I see why I've been wasting my entire life. I've wasted my entire life and I see why, and I don't have to do that anymore, because I can give up all this effort to remove the blocks. And then I'm saying, I'm allowing, then my attention then is turned in the right direction. And then I can experience this continuously, the reminder of reality. Because you're not trying to figure out, well, how'd that happen? How that happened implies that there's some way that it cannot happen. But there's no way it cannot happen. People say, wait a minute, I'm not ready. I gotta remove this block first. Says who? The ego says that. The ego says, hey, look at all those blocks to the awareness of love's presence. You need to work and do meditation, all the stuff you need to do, all the stuff to get rid of that block. Get rid of that block. Change this bar, what it's made of, change this. Oh, you got so much work to do. Nonsense. That's all a total lie of the ego. Don't need to do anything. Nobody will ever need to do anything at all. No pattern of sensations need to do anything to be permeated by the fragrance of truth. Nothing stands in the way, and there's nothing standing in the way. Never has been, never will be. And so these conflicts that we have don't matter. They're not bar of sensation. Disagreements and all that stuff, that doesn't block anything. So you see, these people have been enlightened. You know, their personalities, they didn't really work on their personalities, or their personality may just be not so great or whatever. Just, it doesn't matter. It has no bearing on it. Was a personality just a collection of sensations? Just a habitual way of collecting sensations is all it is. So one drops judgment on the personality entirely. Personality doesn't matter at all. There's no reason to judge it at all. And then anyone can get it this instant. Like the thief on the cross with Jesus, he got it. That instant, Jesus says, you got it. That's it. You're in paradise. You're going to be in paradise. You got it. Just say, what I am, sensation-wise, doesn't matter. Doesn't block anything. Completely transparent, as it were. Has no capacity to block remembrance of what I am. None. Zero. Never has had any. So this is what's going through my day, and seeing this, and recognizing it, and just saying, wow, I like that. That's really, yeah, I need to do nothing. I don't need to do anything. That's for sure. Don't need to do anything. Nobody needs to do anything. And this is what dawns on people, hearing this, that they start to say, well, maybe that's true. You know, wait a minute now. Is that possible? Is it possible that I've just been wasting my time? Is I just been tricked? My whole life is just been tricked? Yes, it is. That's true. That's it. We've simply been deceiving ourselves, tricking ourselves our entire life, thinking we need to do something first. And we say, wait. I don't want to be reminded yet. I'm not ready. Wait, I have to do something first. There's nothing we need to do first. When you say, well, how did you do it? That's a ridiculous question. There's nothing we need to do first. That's the answer. There's nothing we need to do first. There's nothing we need to do at all. When you say, how? They think, what did you remove? How did you let it in? No, they didn't remove anything. They don't need to remove anything. And it's this seeing this, it changes the dynamic of acceptance here. Because you see, truth is not trying to push itself, trying to force us to experience, be reminded of it. It's not trying to force anything. It's just waiting for our willingness and acceptance to say, ah, I don't need to do anything. With sensation, it's not necessary. So, this is what's happening now. We're headed towards the 26th, right? Yeah, we're headed towards the 26th. So these are great days, 26th, 27th, 28th, or through the 31st. This next week, it should be a day of realization, enlightenment in the world. Light, how does light see light? Ask yourself that question. If you're in trouble, if you're in trouble with whatever, sensation, right? You're in trouble with some sensation. You're in trouble with sensation. You just ask yourself this question of, how does light see light? What is light seeing light? What is that? How does light see light? What is light's take on light? Light's perception of light, light's seeing of light. What is that? How does light see light? How does that, what is that experience like of light seeing light? And that seems to stop things in the tracks, right? Not how we see light, how everything else see light. How does light see light? What's the light experience of light? That will has some great effect somehow. And then you say, you know, I don't need to do anything. I don't need to do anything. Nobody needs to do a thing. Right this instant. That means right this instant. It makes this instant available, doesn't it? When nobody, you realize nobody has to do anything. You feel the instant is available to you then. You don't need to wait. You don't need to wait on someone. Nobody has to do something for you. Provide a sensation. No, nobody has to do anything. That awakens the instant, as it were. The holy instant. It awakens it. So, very great. I'm sure people are struggling here and there. I went to bed last night. I thought, you know, just a tremendous day, great focus, wonderful, felt great. And then I was woken up at 3 in the morning by this horrible conflict. Wow. So, at any moment we can be in this conflict. Wow, this terrible feeling of conflict and everything, and we have to persevere on the spiritual path of realization. We don't need to do anything. Don't need to get rid of conflict. Don't need to have good relationships, bad relationships. Don't need to get rid of loneliness. Don't need to get rid of depression. Don't need to do anything at all. Nothing. Don't need to get rid of sickness, pain, you name it. Don't have to do anything at all. And accepting that then will be available to accept in our spirit, say, okay, let the remembrance come. Let the remembrance come and arrive now. I'll experience that instead of sensation. See, instead of sensation. Because you're accepting sensation then is not a block to it. You see, that's the point, the hard point for us. We keep thinking we can block reality. There's some way to keep it out. There is no way to keep it out. So once we accept there is no way to keep it out, then we say, okay, I can experience it then. I won't retreat into fear. You see, I won't retreat into fear. Because all the sensation is an attempt really to block out truth, reality. It is. The prison bars are designed to keep out truth. Keep out truth. And we finally realize, now if we cannot keep it out, then everything pivots on that. So, a lot is going to come up now. From the end of October, you know, it's just going to accelerate in the world so much, so much, so much, so much. So this to reach enlightenment at this time is very auspicious, actually. And we're certainly right there, as it were, just sitting right there. And so I expect whatever to happen, whatever happens, happens, but we'll just be available for it. And this is the time to do that. This is absolutely the time to do it. Don't want to wait and procrastinate and say, well, I wonder what sensations, maybe I can do something more to change the world or something. No, nobody has to change the world at all. Nothing has to happen in the world at all. We don't need to get rid of pollution. We don't need to change anything at all. None of it blocks the awareness, the remembrance of reality. None of it blocks it. We don't need to make this world a beautiful place. That's like painting a bar a pretty color, you know, a bar in the prison cell. It doesn't change the facts. It doesn't make it any easier or more difficult for the fragrance to get through. It doesn't do anything. Painting the bars, decorating the bars, nothing at all. So let this realization, when it hits, it can be very powerful and profound, and just sit with it. And it's kind of actually a happy thought. If you really see it through, you realize, wow, everybody's free right now. And all this world doesn't stop it, doesn't prevent it. No matter what happens in this world, doesn't prevent it. doesn't stop it. Fragrance of freedom is omnipresent. It's already here. Nobody is distanced from it. Nobody is blocked from it at all. Nobody, in no circumstance, can block it at all. Never. All right. Very great. That's it for this one.